Welcome to Highway 89, Utah's most scenic musical byway. I'm Peggy Woodruff. I wish that you could peek in the studio right now because the scene is really quite wonderful. Today, all the way from Taipei, Taiwan, we have the Taiwan Folk Music Ensemble, comprised of a number of artists of all ages and their leaders. And we have some host families here, too, new friends and fans of the musicians who are helping them during their stay. The occasion for all of this is the Springville World Folk Fest, one of the largest festivals of folk dance and music in the United States, which takes place each summer just a few miles down the road from here in Springville, Utah. The festival was founded in 1986 and has since hosted dancers from more than 45 countries. The festival kicks off with a mayor's reception and gift exchange at the Springville Art Museum, followed by a week-long run of outdoor performances at the state-of-the-art amphitheater in Arts Park. We'll learn more about the festival throughout the program, but first let's get to know the music. The Taiwan Folk Music Ensemble will perform two songs about love. The first is titled in English, Spring Breeze, about a young girl longing for her lover. The second is The Moonlight Reflects My Feelings for You. Here's the Taiwan Folk Music Ensemble.
Thank you.
The Moonlight Reflects My Feelings for You and Spring Breeze, performed live by the Taiwan Folk Music Ensemble. This is an international episode of Highway 89. I'm Peggy Woodruff. Out of regard for those of us Americans who have trouble with Chinese names, the performers are using English names. I'll first visit with Seven, who is the director of the Taiwan Folk Music Ensemble, as well as a musician in the ensemble. He plays the Chinese flute, but today is on keyboard. Seven, welcome. You're the director of the ensemble. Are you also the founder?
Yes, I founded the ensemble in 2007.
Were you able to participate in something similar to this when you were young?
No, this is something I have enjoyed
as an adult. Good. Thank you so much, Seven. I'll let you go back to your keyboard. And we will hear two pieces. The first will be Chardash Dance for Erhu solo. The Erhu is a stringed bowed instrument which can be traced back to instruments more than 1,000 years ago. It has a long vertical stick-like neck with two tuning pegs at the top and a resonator box covered with python skin at the bottom. And the bow passes between the strings instead of over them. After Chardash Dance, we will hear a piece called Yangming in Early Spring. This piece is for Chinese flute solo and is inspired by blossoming flowers on Mount Yangming.
Thank you.
Yangming in early spring for Chinese flute, and before that, we heard Chardash dance for Erhu solo. I'm Peggy Woodruff, and this is an international episode of Highway 89. Our musicians are from the Taiwan Folk Music Ensemble and are in town this week to perform at the Springville World Folk Fest. I hope you could hear the bird calls in that first piece, the Chardash. No, it was Yangming in early spring. Marvelous music today. I'm going to visit for a moment with Donna Breckenridge, who is the general director of the Springville World Folk Festival. Donna, welcome to Highway 89.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
You've been associated with the festival in several different capacities over the years. How did you first connect with the festival?
We started in 1990. I don't even remember who first asked us to host a couple of musicians, but we ended up with two from Mexico and have been involved almost every year since then.
And this year you're hosting some artists from the festival in your home?
We have two of the Taiwanese musicians.
Wonderful. Yes. Have you been able to stay in touch with any of the people that you've hosted in the past, or are you kind of like ships passing in the night?
Sometimes the language barrier makes us just ships passing in the night, but I keep in touch with a number of them, yes.
Mm-hmm. How fun this must be. What do you enjoy most about the Folk Fest?
I think I enjoy hearing the stories from the other host families. We have some host families who have kept in touch over 20 years.
Wow.
And go back and forth to Europe to visit with their original guests, and the original guests come here. and they exchange homes for vacations. And when the groups come back, maybe 5 or 10 years later, they want to stay with their original host families. But we have a lot of good things come from Folk Fest.
Wonderful. And you have groups from different countries every year, don't you?
We do. We try not to get one country 2 years in a row, but sometimes that happens.
So much wonderful folk music throughout the world.
Thank you.
It's so fun to have it here in Springville.
It is. It's a wonderful week.
Donna, thank you so much for coming and for working with the festival. This is a wonderful visit from the Taiwan Folk Ensemble. Well, we'll let them get back to their music. We're going to hear two more songs. The first is called The Joy of Being a Farmer. It's one of Taiwan's most popular children's songs, and it's about a grasshopper teasing a rooster. And second will be Here's a Rose for You. It's a Tibetan melody about a girl dancing and singing in a field. And it will be played by our pipa soloist, whose name is Linda. No, Steffi. Thank you. That was Here's a Rose for You, a pipa solo that was played by Steffi. A pipa is a four-stringed Chinese instrument which is plucked rather than bowed. Looks like a pear-shaped guitar with a shorter neck and a larger body, and it's held upright. They go way back and were mentioned in the second century. Before that, we heard The Joy of Being a Farmer. You're listening to an international edition of Highway 89. I'm Peggy Woodruff. Lillian is our interpreter today, and she plays Chinese flute as well. Lillian, welcome.
Thank you. It's our honor to be here.
Do you come from a musical family? Do other members play?
Yes, actually, I have an aunt that plays viola in the Juilliard and Curtis.
Whoa!
Yeah, and also have an uncle, and he sings very well. He teaches voice.
When did you start playing the flute?
From my eighth grade. Yes.
And how long have you been with this group?
I've been in this group for like 2 years, but I went to another festival with our directors before.
Yes. Wonderful. Now, you help young performers play and perform at festivals around the world. What are some of the countries that your ensemble has visited?
They visit Italy and Portugal, Spain, Belgium, France, and Switzerland. And this year, we're very honored to be in Utah.
We're so happy to have you here in Utah. I understand you were born in the United States.
Yes.
Where?
In Philadelphia.
In Philadelphia.
Yes.
Wow, we're glad to have you back. There's a troupe of dancers that are also part of the ensemble.
Yes.
How often do the musicians and the dancers rehearse together?
They rehearse together for about 3 months. And before that, they actually practice separately. Yeah,
I see.
They combine the two arts together and present it to you.
You had your first performance last night, didn't you?
Yes.
How did it go?
It's wonderful. We feel so great to be there and to have all the audience down there and to talk and to play with the other artists from all around the world.
Well, Lillian, we would love to hear some more of the music of the Taiwan Folk Music Ensemble. I'll let you go back to your flute.
Thank you.
And I'll tell our listeners that now we're going to hear another piece for Erhu solo. This is called Horse Race, which describes people racing horses on endless grasslands. We heard Horse Race, performed by the artists and directors of the Taiwan Folk Music Ensemble of Taipei, Taiwan. And that concludes this international edition of Highway 89. I thoroughly enjoyed the music. Special thanks to all of our guests, and especially to you, Seven, director of the group, for bringing your musicians here. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
You are a remarkable group, and I have developed a great love for your music over the last few minutes. The Taiwan Folk Music Ensemble is one of the many ensembles performing this week in Springville, Utah. Founded in 1986, the Springville World Folk Fest is now one of the largest folk festivals in the United States. Complete information about the festival and how to be a part of it is available at worldfolkfest.com. Highway 89 takes you to any number of musical destinations, every one of them musical and memorable. We always welcome comments and questions. To contact us, simply send us an email to highway89@byu.edu. Highway 89 is a production of BYU Broadcasting. The recording engineer is Mark Waite. The show's producer is Jackie Tataishi. I'm Peggy Woodruff. Thank you for listening.